The Honourable Leader of the New Democratic Party.
Thank you. Mr. Speaker, this question is for the Premier. With this week's reopening to 100% capacity in retail and fitness centres and so on, we know that many more people are going to be going to work. We also know that after only long-term care, the most prominent place for the transmission of the COVID virus is people's workplaces. Because we have no paid sick leave in Nova Scotia, there's a risk that should an outbreak occur, the frontline lower paid workers in these workplaces would not be able to afford to stay home and get tested and stop the spread. Mr. Speaker, will the Premier acknowledge that many people are in the untenable position of not being able to follow the public health guidelines because they are not in a position to miss a day's pay?
The Honourable Premier.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. And what I've said very clearly, that if Nova Scotians are sick, then they should stay home, Mr. Speaker. They have that right. And during this COVID plan, we've seen the federal government come out with many different programs. We do our best to fill the gaps. They come out with programs to support labour, including a sick benefit that Nova Scotians are eligible for. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
The Honourable Leader of the New Democratic Party.
Mr. Speaker, a right is only as good as the situation's capacity for it to be made effective. So we have reports emerging from other parts of the country and here in Nova Scotia too, that frontline workers, even some of those in nursing homes, have come to the conclusion that they can't afford to take the time from work to get vaccinated. Their work isn't covering for them for the time to go and make the appointment. And without there being any statutory sick leave, they're not covered for the day that they might need to rest after some of the associated side effects with getting the vaccine. So I want to ask the Premier if he's considered how Nova Scotia's lack of paid sick days has the possibility and potential to put our vaccine program at risk.
The Honourable Premier.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. We need to continue to look at ways that we support Nova Scotians in this budget. We have a number of programs. I did look at what other provinces offer for sick benefit. There is no other province that offers what the member is proposing in this province, Mr. Speaker. We need to continue to support Nova Scotians, and if they're sick, they need to stay home. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
The Honourable Leader of the New Democratic Party.
There is, however, a province which has gone backwards on paid sick days, Mr. Speaker. That is Ontario, and that is not a situation that we want to find ourselves in. We want to be going ahead. A doctor there in ICU shared on Twitter over the weekend this, that it took a total of 5 MDs, 4 ICU RCNs, 4 RTs, 1 perfusionist, and 3 paramedics, 3 hours to save the life of his 140-year-old COVID-19 patient. And by contrast, he said, it would have cost $114, that's 8 hours at minimum wage there, to have allowed her husband to take a day off work from the plant where he worked, where there was a known outbreak. But without paid sick days, he wasn't in a position to do that. He got COVID, his wife got COVID, and her doctor said this, we have lost our way. Mr. Speaker, I want to ask the Premier, with the Provincial Labour Standards Code squarely within the responsibility and the purview of the province, why does he continue to insist that paid sick days are the responsibility of something other than his own government and himself?
The Honourable Premier.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and we're going to continue to look at what other provinces do, what the federal government provides for support for Nova Scotians, and we are in a pandemic, but we're doing much better than other provinces, especially the one that the member references in terms of what's happening with the epidemiology. We continue to keep our cases low. The risk is low in this province, and we continue to keep our schools open. We have our businesses opening more and more. We're going to continue to watch that very closely and lead the country in how we manage this pandemic. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.